So you want to know why you should study computer networks. I will get to that shortly, but before that, let me ask you a question. Majority must have answered, I need to do this course to get a degree. Well, there is that. But let me give a few other good reasons on why you should study computer networks. At the end of this video, hopefully, instead of doing this course under compulsion, you will do it with a lot more enthusiasm. Let's start out by identifying the utility of computer networks via listing some internet services that you regularly use. I guess everyone knows what an internet is, but some of you may not know how this word is derived. So if you see internet, this inter refers to interconnecting. Net refers to networks, basically computer networks. So internet basically interconnects different computer networks. That is how this word is derived. So answer this first. There you go. The power of internet is making us lazier by the day. So you must have chosen the answer chat. So communication, a very fundamental human need, is greatly simplified by internet services. So we have emails, we have chat, we can do voice calls, we can do video over Skype, so on. So how do you entertain yourself? Answer the following. Entertainment, another fundamental need, and the internet provides a variety of options. There is online gaming, plenty of videos you can watch on YouTube, you can read about blogs, you can connect with your friends on social networks such as Facebook and Twitter. Education, probably not as fundamental a need as entertainment, but nonetheless, internet can help in this regard as well. So there are wikis from which you can learn new stuff, you can get to know what's happening in the world, and there's a whole lot of MOOCs platforms where you can do such courses online. So there are other aspects like finance and commerce. There is online shopping. You don't even have to step out of the house. You can finish your shopping. Similarly, you could do online banking and take care of your finances. I guess the point that is being made here is internet is very helpful for various things on the personal front. There's a business angle as well where you will find internet useful. So a lot of companies like to make their data programs or even equipment available irrespective of the physical location of the employees. Now this data could be in the form of customer employee records, inventory of what is there in the company, or the financial statements. Now the programs that you like to share could be in the form of custom software or security software. And equipment could be in the form of shared printers or scanners. You don't want to buy one printer per user, rather you'll buy just a few and everyone has to share it. So this makes many companies have global reach, which is very desirable. And certain e-commerce companies like Amazon, eBay or Flipkart won't even be in existence if not for computer networks. So all in all, internet, basically a communication network for information exchange, has significantly enriched our lives, both on the personal side as well as the business side. Now, when you throw in wireless networking, you get total freedom from wires, which makes anytime, anywhere communication. So you get few additional services in the form of cellular Wi-Fi access, that is communication while mobile. Then you have satellite TV for your entertainment with GPS, you get maps, location information, so on. And now there is some out of ordinary as well as futuristic usage. Some of you have heard the term Internet of Things. Basically, you connect smart objects to the internet, like your toaster or your electric bulb. Now you're wondering, why would you want to connect such objects to the internet? Again, this permits you to control these devices. So for example, if you forgot to turn off the bulb while you left your home, once you get to office, you can just turn them off from office. There are quite a lot of such interesting things out there. Near field communication is another. So for example, in Google Wallet, when you go to a grocery shop, you check out everything and all you do is tap your smartphone on some device and you're done paying the money. So it's as simple as that. And then there is interplanetary internet. Why restrict ourselves with communication within Earth? Let's talk with things on Jupiter, Mars, so on. So that's again another interesting area. Nothing makes a point better than statistics to highlight the impact of internet. So let me throw some numbers at you. So as of June 2015, there are 3 billion internet users, that is 40% of the world population. India, there are about 243 million users. Unfortunately, we don't have as good a penetration. It's only 19% of our population. Guess the number of emails that get sent in 1 second. A mind-boggling 2 million emails get sent in 1 second. Of course, 67% of it is spam. We have a little under 1 billion websites as of now. And again, a huge, tremendous number of videos are watched per second. It's not per minute, it's per second at YouTube. 1 lakh videos, unbelievable. People have too much free time. And we have 1 billion Facebook users. It's a huge number of Facebook users. And there are 50,000 Google searches performed in 1 second. See these numbers, they're really mind-boggling. Such high usage, such high impact of computer networks. So by the way, these statistics have been taken from this particular website. It is nice if you just go visit this website. They have a lot more other interesting statistics there as well. So you're wondering, enough already, what does all this mean to me? So as you see, we are highly dependent on internet and there is a huge demand for internet services. What does this mean? It means there are plenty of job opportunities out there. Working in this area is also very exciting. There's plenty of scope for innovation. How do you speed up your internet access? How do you scale the internet so that we can actually serve 100% of the world population? Even if you don't intend to work or innovate in this specific area, some basic knowledge will help you understand debug networks. After all, we are heavily dependent on them, and you can earn brownie points from your friends and family, especially when you come, you debug and help them solve the problem. They'll all be very thrilled. I guess this is enough to motivate you to do this course with a lot of enthusiasm. So before I end this video, let me also cover the goals of the course. The first goal is basically to appreciate the challenges posed in computer networks. Let me emphasize that we will focus on wired networks. We will touch briefly upon wireless, but the focus of this course is mainly on wired computer networks. And we will understand how some of these challenges are overcome at different layers of the protocol stack. So this computer networks are organized as layers. We will see what these layers are shortly. And each layer comes with its own set of challenges, and we will understand how these challenges are solved at each layer. Now, during this process, we will get to know a few popular standards as well as protocols. For example, we will learn about the Ethernet standard, what is this IPv4 standard, TCP standard, HTTP standard, so on, as well as some other protocols as well as algorithms. And we will also try to implement, experiment some of these ideas we have learned above in the form of projects and labs so that you get a better feel for what is happening. And while I do all this, periodically I will also try to provide a high level overview of the ongoing research as well as hot topics in this space. So that's it. To summarize, we live in an information age. We are bombarded with information. There's a high dependence on computer networks, be it on the personal or the business front. So it has seen a tremendous growth, and this growth is expected to continue. Thereby, it is useful to understand how computer networks work so that we can be a part of this revolution.